Did you and your family or friends spend any money yesterday on meals, drinks in restaurants, cafes, pubs or takeaways? Can you tell me how much?
These are the questions. The answers will shape a strategy for London's Visitor and Convention Bureau, who want to know how much tourists spend, on what and where, how many people they keep in work, and what Londoners think of them. The questions aren't new. Money to replace guesstimates with answers is.
Will you be staying in London for more than 3 months?
An industry accustomed to steady growth took a battering when Arab extremists scared American visitors. It was left to the Duke and Duchess of York to show the world that London was a safe and pleasant place to visit. Business is better, but even the Visitor Bureau must admit that London isn't at ease with its tourist industry.
It's gradually changing, but it isn't really positive enough yet. No one's really fully appreciated how advantageous to London's economy tourism is.
Boroughs who once confined tourism to the centre are looking for a slice of the action and offering an offbeat look at London. Can Camden Passage rival New York's Greenwich Village? Can Erith provide a riverside Riviera between capital city and Channel Port? A new guide exploring outer London will be published next month, plugging little-known museums, curiosity corners and old houses. The government leave it all to quangos and market forces, but some would like a tourist tax and a tourist authority with teeth.
There's no planning of tourism whatsoever, and it's all based on exploitation. Exploitation of tourists and exploitation of the people who actually work in the tourist industry. And I think that for such an important industry, a great deal more thought has to go into it.
If not?
In the end, there'll be a rising resentment against tourists by Londoners, and there'll be tourists feeling they're not really welcome in this great capital city, and they won't bother to come.
9 million overseas visitors and 14 million domestic visitors came to London last year, but the business traveller spends twice as much as the humble holidaymaker. With a QE2 as a flagship, London will soon boast a plethora of conference venues and exhibition halls. With an old agricultural hall converted into a business design centre in Islington, a rebuilt Alley Pally and an extended Wembley complex, London can at last rival Paris as a conference venue.
Well, I think we've got just as many attractions, just as much atmosphere and world popularity, but I don't think in London we've begun yet to really value tourism in the way that they do over there. They're much more logical about it.
And Paris spends more than London on its tourist industry. But the French have just invested £31 million to fly the Meridian flag in London's Piccadilly for business bookings or tourist traffic.
There are two seasons a year. There's one which is the business season, which is about 6 to 7 months a year. And then there is another season, which is the summer season and part of the winter, where you get more of a tourist traffic.
Better planning and more marketing might balance the two. While tourists snap sights and monitor menus, economists measure money and count jobs. At the bottom end of the market, wages are poor, conditions bleak, but at a five-star hotel like the Meridian, careers can be built in one of our few growth industries. Janice started as a chambermaid. She's now a housekeeper.
You're staying just with one night?
Joanne stepped from catering college to the reception desk and hopes to become a manager. Jonathan is a junior chef with a very definite ambition.
I'd like to end up running my own restaurant, at least, well, possibly four.
350 people work at this one hotel, but planning for new hotels in the West End is virtually impossible, finance for hotels in outer London difficult. Denied might or muscle, the LVCB hopes that facts and figures can bring London and its tourists together. The promised blueprint will be published in the spring. David Bellin, Thames News.
Anyway, so you have to come down a bit, because he won't let you film from up there.